No, yeah, I didn't bring my headphones.
That's it, dude. We don't listen to it on the headphones at this point. It's too far anyway. We'd have to go sit next to the board. Yeah.
Who wants to sit next to the board? Those guys smell.
Is it going? Are we going?
Yeah, we're on, dude. I mean, I'm talking shit about the sound guys.
Yeah. Yeah.
Help me out.
Welcome to
we are here.
We're talking shit about the sound guys that smell.
I didn't say it.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I mean, they are running our sound.
Yes, they are.
Yeah, we'll see we'll see. We'll see. So it's a beautiful day here in South Decatur.
Yeah, it's about 55 degrees.
Did it warm up to that?
Yeah, last I checked, but it's pretty nice.
It's all right. It's all right. We were playing out in the shed earlier. It's if you had to pick one word before you saw it today, Matty. If you had to pick one word to describe the shed, what would it be?
Crammed.
That's what she said. Oh no, that's what Shed said. Yeah. No, it's. Oh, there you go. There's Mama Cat.
That's the mother.
I believe so. You see how she looks like that other one that you saw.
Big fluffy tail.
There are some fluffy cats. Some of them have stripes. Dude, I was checking her out earlier. She's got these. She's got this black fur on the pads of her feet.
Wow.
It's really cool.
Well, are they furrier now because it's getting cold?
Well, my cat hasn't stopped shedding yet. My cat is always shedding.
Yeah?
Cats always shed. I don't care what they say. But we're not here to talk about the shed today.
Shed? The cat's shedding?
Can you hear the clock?
No.
Okay. Clock is on.
I can't. What was that? Is that a plane?
That's a plane.
Okay. You get used to that. Not audible on the
I recording. Guarantee you that it is.
I thought the rain was going to be audible on that last one, and I didn't hear anything. It actually sounded nice.
I liked having our theme music better. I liked it when we had music.
But
that was pretty cool.
What do you mean
Steely Dan.
Yeah. We're talking about Steely Dan.
Yeah, we were talking about Steely Dan. We're talking about Steely Dan today on Age of the Shrug.
Yes.
That's the goal today.
That's the goal.
That is the project. So, favorite album?
Favorite album is Asia.
Asia?
Yeah.
I mean, you were just making fun of the black cow just now.
I wasn't making fun of him.
Yeah, you were. You were boop, 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 poop, poop, and
black cow. I love that song. I kid Steely Dan because I love. Yeah, it's. What is it? It's that indescribable corniness that Steely Dan has that you have to break through if you're gonna really enjoy him, because you can't be.
I don't hear corniness. I hear jadedness.
No.
You know. I mean.
Oh no no. This is what happens when. You set a standard in music that people come to meet afterwards, you know, for commercials. And Steely Dan had hit songs that advertising companies and whatnot, they'd be like, oh, let's have our theme music sound like that, you know. And so there was a lot of bad synergy where you had the real Steely Dan, but then you had
the soundalikes.
The soundalikes.
Yeah.
Okay,
so have you ever noticed this phenomenon? I don't know if you've ever noticed. I notice this. If I play my music in one room, right?
Yeah.
And I'm standing in another room, and I'll try to name that song. The music can sound so different. You know, I'll think that I'm listening to Steely Dan, and I'll come down and find it's Van Halen. I think it's going to be, some Camper Van Beethoven, and I come down and it's Charles Mingus.
That's like when you're going to you pick up a cup and you think it's going to be Coke, and you drink it, and it's tea.
But it still tastes like Coke.
Right, for a second, until you panic and think. It was tea.
See, I do that shit with milk and beer all the time. Yeah. I'm reaching in the fridge and I'm looking at the milk and it's terrible.
Yeah, it's really this. There's a period where you're fooled.
Is there a name for that?
Probably. I'll bet you there probably
is. If anyone knows the name for that, yeah. I could use that. I could use that word.
Right in.
That's a good word.
And tell us, because I tell you, I don't know how to pronounce it, but there's misophonia or misophonia where you can't stand the sound of other people chewing.
Yeah, I've heard of this.
I'm full blown on that shit. I cannot stand it.
Didn't we do a lot of Foley of people eating? And I know we did a lot of loud drinking.
Yes.
Because we had to do loud drinking for the piss drinking.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's...
Yeah, where you gotta get throat sounds and whatnot. But,
I love this part.
Damn it.
He forgot what he was going to say.
Have I brought this up before where the Simpsons, in the first season of the Simpsons, there's always a scene where they eat noisily.
Oh, yeah, where they're sitting at the breakfast table. I don't know if that... didn't they do a parody of that in which they made it even more obnoxious than it was originally? And that is what we confuse now with the real memory?
It might be, it was pretty obnoxious. They did it in the original Tracy Ullman shorts, and it carried over to...
Carried
over to the first season.
Yeah.
And it's just the most nauseating thing.
Well, I mean, imagine if The Simpsons had stayed the show it was in the first, two, three seasons. If it had just, stayed there.
Ish.
Which, if it were to be, if a new series were to start now, it would have to be pigeonholed as it was originally. And it would not be allowed to.
Grow.
Yeah.
So it'd be these weird looking characters that spaz out all the time, and Bart used to go like his eyes would point in different directions. Do you remember this?
Yeah. It's
26 years ago, but
the drawings have definitely changed, evolved over the years. And I don't know if I like the super sleek look of the new cartoons. And
I think the best it got was in the movie. That was like a decent compromise between the way it used to look and the way it became, but it did get very antiseptic looking for a little while.
Yeah, we're about to get some garbage action.
Garbage.
Here come the garbage truck.
I wonder. I bet you this will be audible. Yeah.
That's good.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I bet he's going to scare all my birds away.
Yeah, they'll come back.
Folks, right before we went on, I had a party of birds out in the front.
Bird party.
It was kicking.
Oh, is that a garbage truck?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, okay. Oh, yeah.
Hey, pick up my fucking garbage, dude.
Yeah, they're getting it.
Are they?
I don't know.
I hope so.
It's funny trying to see this through a curtain.
Yeah.
It's...
It's designed not to be seen through.
Right. You get, the least amount of visual information.
Dude, in this room, we're pretty isolated.
Yeah, which is good.
It's not... We do have one window out onto the world, so it's not completely a bunker.
Right.
And, but, I mean, it's a view of concrete and a fence.
Yeah, if we were to describe it, it would sound really bleak and brutalist.
Unless you walked around the corner and I could give you an inventory of my junk sale.
I'm a big fan of brutalist architecture. The word brutalist. Brutalist.
You just like to say brutalist.
Yeah, I like the word brutal. I like to describe things as brutal.
Here, have a drink, Mike.
Oh, wow. Peripheral vision is a funny thing, man.
A moment of silence.
So Steely Dan.
Oh, right. Back to the Dan. We are discussing Steely Dan today on this episode of Age of the Shrug. This is the Steely Dan episode. Yeah. So I'm waiting for you, Matty, to ask me what my favorite album is.
What is
Countdown
your
to Ecstasy.
That's... Yeah.
It's my favorite. It's It's the one I go to. I kept Countdown to Ecstasy in my car for about a month once and just...
It's
just listen to
almost
it.
As perfect as Asia is.
Hey, don't talk about my girl like that.
I mean, you know, flaws are a good thing.
It is very, it's, it fucking rocks. It
has
rocks.
My old school on it.
It rocks. It,
which, my old school is.
It makes you move. Asia is just a little bit too cerebral pretentious.
Okay,
you know?
Asia is much more loungy.
There you go.
Yeah. I don't mean like lounge music. I mean like you put it on.
Yeah, but it's
it.
Yeah, it's
Countdown to Ecstasy will get you on your feet.
Exactly. And that's
my old school. I have been listening to that.
Showbiz
song.
Kids, man.
Yeah.
Showbiz Kids is where it's at, and of course the track that we just listened to.
Right. Showbiz Kids, of course, has fuck in it. Has the word fuck in it. This is going to sound insane.
I'll do everyone a favor and not sing it.
This is going to sound insane, but occasionally, songs with the word shit or fuck would just be on the radio, and nobody made a big deal about it. There was the Rolling Stones song Star Star.
Yeah, Starfucker.
Right. There's, I mean, I'm thinking of Showbiz Kids, but there's another one. It's not Steely Dan. There's another song that has...
Is it the Eagles?
I think it's an Eagles song that has fuck in it or shit.
I think it's shit.
I don't know. But these were... Okay, we would hear it in...
There's
like,
a
art
Steve
class.
Miller song. Steve Miller band that has
right.
funky shit going down in the city.
Yeah. You know, we'd be in art class in grade school, and the radio would be on, and one of these songs would come on, and we all go, ee! And then, you know, you'd move on. It wasn't a big deal. You would occasionally hear a dirty word on the radio. Money by Pink Floyd. That was the one that had bullshit.
Over this good bullshit.
Yeah, and that's the one that usually I would hear at school. And nobody made a big deal out of it because there was a certain kind of reverence towards Pink Floyd.
Shouldn't be a big deal, you know. I mean,
it's just a word.
Well, and I mean, it used to be that it was incumbent upon the jockey to hit the cough button, when that song was coming on, and then they got into the practice of recording a radio version, and you know, if you bought the album, you would get the sanitized radio version,
right.
And then exactly that's the case in point that I'm thinking of, but they weren't the only instance, and now you know I don't know if I understand or care to understand anything that they're saying, so
no,
they could be swearing for all I know.
What am I going to learn from a contemporary pop song? Exactly.
Yeah. So, Steely Dan though.
Mm-hmm.
Steely Dan. I wish that Becker and Fagan would just go ahead and co-author a novel. And
they kind of did.
The liner notes?
The liners.
Those lines, that's a short story, you know. It may be several short stories. A collection of short stories.
Yeah. I'm sure it wouldn't
seven
add up
stories.
Too much. I mean, you could probably space out the letters and make it a nice little paperback.
I mean, it's... I don't know if they make 1,000 words per liner in some of them, but...
Oh, sure. It's real funny text. Oh, yeah. For people who don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, the Steely Dan reissues from... I think it was 1999 till about 2000.
Do you have all of them?
Yeah.
Do you have them all?
I have all the reissues, yeah.
I want to... They're
connects
through... I'm missing Pretzel Logic. I got an old... release of Pretzel Logic, and I just couldn't see spending the money to Ricky.
To Ricky Don't Listen to Number, which always confuses me, and I go, what?
Well, and then have Horace Silver, Song for My Father.
Horace Silver, Song for My Father. Put that on.
Just YouTube that thing.
YouTube it. And
close your eyes, and for the first 10 seconds, you know.
Wait a minute.
You might not know which decade you're in for a while.
Did Ricky lose that number?
Ricky lost that number and inserted a lot more horns.
Yeah, I don't know if Ricky's...
That's a great song, too, though.
It really is. That was my knee popping.
Oh, nice.
I don't know if that was audible.